This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
We return to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Positive Friday coming up. We will drink, toast into the weekend and the exciting return of Bad Choice Friday.
You know it's Bad Choice Friday.
It's Bad Choice Friday.
This is your fault.
So spooky with DJ Jazzy spooky. Jeff and the Fresh Prince.
Spooky. There's a nightmare on my street.
Spook.
Is this not the spookiest voice ever?
Boo. Yes, it's DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince taking on Ray Parker Jr.
Something strange in your neighborhood.
Come on.
The police.
This guy got laid for this.
I know.
That's amazing. He was the man. That's amazing. A very spooky Halloween-inspired Bad Choice Friday. Will it be a nightmare on my street or Ghostbusters? If you follow us on Twitter,
got a clown in your drain.
Get there and vote now. One of those two tunes coming up right after the
Something
shot of the day.
Strange and it don't look good. STD.
Don't eat it.
Who are you going to call? Your doctor.
Don't eat it.
Right.
Our question, what did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Comment here. It says, my son eats peanut butter and dill pickle sandwiches. He got this from his dad, who loved them. That from Tammy. Tammy, that is freaking disgusting. That is disgusting. Hello, Rachel. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Hola.
I grew up and ate tripe, which is in menudo, but I will eat tripe all the time now. And then I also eat gizzards.
What, the chicken variety?
Yeah.
What do you do? Do you go to a butcher and just ask for like a container of chicken gizzards? How does that work out?
You can just buy them at the store.
They charge you? I mean, honestly, I feel like if I'm a butcher, right, and you roll up and you say, hey, my name's Rachel, and I like gizzards. I go, like, I'm not going to charge you for this because I'm not
Rachel,
going to use them for anything
I have understood and heard of gizzards. My grandmother used to put those when she would make the stock for gravy, you know, eat all
they went to other things, sure.
What is the gizzard?
It's the part of the body that processes gross stuff. But it's delicious when you eat it and put seasoning.
Are you saying it's the liver of the chicken?
Or I thought gizzards were all the little intestines.
It's not the liver, it's
or
the gizzard.
Organs.
But I think the gizzards are specific.
All right.
To one of the organs. Like my grandfather used to eat those, but he also ate
so is the heart,
chicken
the
foot
lungs,
sandwiches.
All those things, are they all considered gizzards as a whole?
I get, in my mind they are, but I don't know because I've never really investigated gizzards too much. Are you a 78-year-old black man? Because in my mind, that's the only other person.
Rachel!
I'm Rachel, the old black man.
No, I'm not.
No, you didn't sound like it. I just figured out, because my grandfather was the only other, and I want to say maybe my grandmother on the other side of the family, but those are the only two people.
My grandfather did it. That was a huge thing every Thanksgiving. He had to have the turkey gizzards.
Okay, Rachel, are you an old white man?
No.
Oh, okay, I'm just checking.
A middle-aged Mexican lady.
Okay.
All right.
As far as tripe, how do you prepare your tripe?
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so most of the time I have it, like, in menudo, which is a Mexican soup.
And a fine band.
But I've had it in tacos and burritos and just kind of...
What is... Because I go to Mexico... Well, back in the days when we could travel, I would try to get there at least once a year. And for sure, tripe tacos were pretty much on every menu. I just never had the guts to order one. Do you think I would like it?
I think you would love them. They're delicious. Mm-hmm. And... It changes the flavor when you put them in a taco because they kind of get a like a crusty and caramelize, and just the flavors come out more when they fry than when it's in the soup. The soup is a little more soft, but it's delicious either way.
I tell you what, and I know you know traditional Mexican cuisine, but you really need to try this out. This was one of the, from the beginning.
If you say Taco Bell, I'm going to quit. Okay.
It's the chimichanga.
Yeah.
I don't know who came up with this thing. It's the most amazing thing ever. Someone accidentally bumped a burrito into the deep fryer. Yep. I'm telling you what, the world changed that day.
It did.
It really did.
That's when you know it got Americanized. Once it gets deep fried, we're like, it's ours now.
It's like fair food.
Right.
What if we took this burrito
and put it in the deep fryer? That's the American way.
And put donkey sauce on top.
Right.
It was called something stupid like chimichanga.
Right. Yeah, people fall for that.
Yeah.
And you know what? You're right. Well, it's freaking delicious.
Thomas from Juarez. They won't know.
They don't travel.
Yeah, so... What did you or do you eat?
Take it, deep fry it, make it your own, brother. That's the United States way. You feel me? Well, escargot, you ever have it deep fried?
That's one of those things, right? Like, I'm one of those people, like, I love Mexican food. It's like, do I or do I like Tex-Mex?
You like the Americanized worst version of everything. Like, orange chicken or General So, right?
Right, but I'm saying that style of Mexican is Tex-Mex.
Tex-Mex. Yeah, I mean, when I go to Mexico, I will say it's... You know, everything reads the same, right? So you'll see taco, burrito, et cetera, blah, 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 but it's just not the same. You know, I mean, it's just not the same at all, man.
I tell you what, the soup is so good in Mexico. That's the problem. It's 95 degrees, and you're sitting there with a bowl of soup going, this is delicious.
You're not kidding.
Is that pozole?
Yeah, it's so hot, it's so good.
It's pozole. They have, like,
traditional tortilla soup.
Yeah, tortilla soup. Mm. And he's right, man. It's 95 degrees outside. It's 95% humidity. You're already sweating, and you're like, I'll have the bowl of soup.
Yeah, it's build your own. You know, cabbage comes in a bowl. All your stuff comes in a bowl. You just toss it in like fuck.
I wish I'd do that when I was a kid.
What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421 Rock.
Yes, Dad. I spend most of my time picking crap out of my food.
You do take more stuff away from your food than you put in your
mouth. Because it's just easier, man. Like, we went to McDonald's today, and it's like, yes, I can order it without pickles, but it's muscle memory, so there's still an 80% chance pickles are going to be on your burger. I'm going to check anyway, just whatever. You just say two
cheeseburgers. Yeah, but if you say new pickles and they hook you up, you're going to get a fresh burger.
If they remember... I got burned once as a kid. I got burned one time as a kid. I mean, a child, like 4 or 5 years old. I remember it because I was in Portsmouth, Virginia, visiting my grandparents. I was very excited that my father ran to McDonald's, came home, got me a cheeseburger, and he even said, without pickle, because I always made that statement as a kid. I bit into it, and there was this big-ass pickle. It tasted horrible, and ever since then, it's like it's not worth it. Always check. Always check.
Yeah, as a kid, I'm with you. The pickle bite was, like, horrifying.
It was.
What?
Oh, yeah, as a kid, I hated it.
Why?
Because I hated pickles.
Because he can taste them.
Now, as an adult, I love it.
I savored the pickle bite.
Really?
Ooh, even as a kid?
Yeah, there's only one pickle in there.
But it should be two.
Oh, they ripped me off. What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Hello, Ian. Welcome to the men's room.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
Positive Friday, Ian.
Positive Friday, indeed. So people seem to think it's kind of weird that I like peanut butter on my burgers.
I don't think you're weird, man.
Yeah, that's a good combo.
Well, I've been there and wait. It's still weird. I know that you guys have tried it and like it.
Yeah, right. More than like
but
it.
But I know that you guys think it's weird because you spent all of your time trying to convince me before I even said anything that it was good. Like, hey, guess what I tried, wherever the hell it was. And you're like, mm-hmm. It was peanut butter on the burger.
It was.
And before you say anything, that's your admission. You know it's weird.
How about the bacon? Did you get the bacon on that peanut butter bacon burger?
Absolutely.
That's the way to go. Yeah, man, that's
Thurl, you are correct.
That's the tip.
I mean, like, you were defensive before anyone even said anything.
But that's kind of how life goes. Once you introduce her to the old whoop, then it's not that weird to her anymore.
Well, if people put jam on their hamburger, too. I mean, you think about the people who do, like, the arugula and the gouda and all that stuff where you go, like, into Fancy Pants Burger Seattle and you get the Fancy Pants Burger. You know, they put jelly on there.
Yeah.
It's fine. It works with a savory kind of jelly.
It's
with a combination that they put together.
But it's not like grape Welch's jelly.
No.
No.
No, it's something they got off of, like, you know, I don't know.
Something you can buy at Trader Joe's.
Or something. You know what I mean? Like, oh, it's local.
It's a handwritten label.
Right, exactly.
Have you seen the Elvis one?
The Elvis.
There's like a famous Elvis sandwich that's like peanut butter and jelly.
Bananas
for sure.
Bananas, bacon, and then a place I saw had bacon, and then they put fried eggs in there, too.
Remember, this is a man who died sitting on the toilet. So,
which
I mean, your choice.
I know. It seems like a hot mess, but I'm just like, I want to try it.
Sure.
It's just too much.
Yeah,
Okay, so like my wife does not mind jelly and bacon sandwiches. In fact, she eats them. She likes them. And I think that's the most revolting thing on earth.
Oh, I've never heard of that. That sounds good.
Jelly and bacon? I'd rather go bacon and peanut butter.
I agree.
Well, sure, but jelly and bacon sounds just fine.
And we're talking just the straight squeeze bottle of grape jelly, right? We got the kids and me. And she got tired of my peanut butter getting stuck in the jelly. Anyway, so she uses the grape jelly, but she throws bacon on there. And I just find it revolting every time. She's like, dude, it's really not that bad. I'm like, I understand that you don't think it's bad because you keep eating it. But that is,
I'll tell you a weird one I do, man. If I go get Thai food, I get a big spoonful of peanut butter and put it on the side of my plate, like a peanut sauce.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that.
Works just fine, man.
But I mean, But peanut sauce is big in Thai food, right?
Yeah, but typically not like in bacon fried rice. You
know, true. Like, although I've used peanut butter to kind of like convince the kids we're having Chinese food night, but it's like soy sauce, sesame oil, peanut butter, chopped up some garlic, threw in some red pepper flakes, beat the living hell out of it, so it was like a sauce, and it wasn't bad.
No, that's good stuff.
Now, I'm not saying it was good. I'm saying that it wasn't bad.
What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-RUN.
I just wanted to be clear about that.
Right.
Oh, she'll beat you with a hot skillet. Hello, Tammy. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Tammy, what tattoo do you have on your back, shoulder?
None.
How about your front right upper breast?
None.
When's the last time you smoked a Pall Mall?
Never.
You're not really a Tammy.
Okay, last chicken pot pie you eat. You ate.
Oh, my God. You guys are killing me.
Who is the last man you hit with a wooden baseball bat?
Who is the mulleted man of your dreams?
An idiot that's far, far away right now.
Uh-huh. Does he have a mullet?
No, never did.
Okay, all right. Man, you're really bringing us down on this whole Tammy thing.
Yeah, I know. If that's your real name.
Okay.
Yes, it is.
All right.
So listen, guys, I have put peanut butter on tamales. It is delicious.
What is it that people seem to think? And look, I admit maybe I'm just not being adventurous, but I'm learning today that peanut butter seems to be this remarkably versatile thing. It like, it seems people are dipping their pickles.
I can't think of any other combination that involves corn product and then peanut butter.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really racking my brain on that. What kind of tamales are we talking about? I mean, are these chicken, are they chorizo, or any?
They're usually a traditional pork tamale. They've got the shredded pork in them.
Okay.
Do you make your own tamales?
Hell no.
I was going to say, that's
okay.
People who make tamales, man, they know how to hook it up.
Rev's wife will make tamales, and because of this, he'll send an email like, look, if you want in, you got to let her know. Right. That
it's a Girl Scout cookie.
Yeah, and I mean, I've gotten some tamales from her. They're delicious. Tammy, let me ask you this. It's one thing to put peanut butter on your tamales, but then I always ask myself, when did you discover that you like peanut butter on your tamales? Were you broke? Were you high? How?
No, I was a kid, and I think there was like a can of tamales, which is the grossest in the world, but I ate them. I was hungry as a kid. I got the peanut butter out, and I was looking at both of them thinking this might be great, and I tried it, and I loved it.
And you still eat it to this day. Like, if you had a really good, fresh, homemade tamale right now, and I was your next-door neighbor, and I brought over a plate of them, you would put peanut butter on there.
I might try it, yes.
I don't think I would ever bring you tamales
again. I'm just kidding.
That would be your last one and done.
Yeah, I don't...
There are some tamales out there that are really good that don't deserve the peanut butter.
I might leave them on the hood of your Camaro and walk away and see if you find them, but I'm not...
I'll leave them on the nylon lawn chair. All right, now let me... Is there any peanut butter that is better than others on a tamale, or is it just like straight up Jif?
I think it's straight up Jif.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. That is... you're a disgusting person.
All right.
I think I am in that respect, yes.
Yeah, tamales and peanut butter.
And I swear I'm stone sober. But a lot of these, I'm like, I got to try this.
That one?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Really? I like tamales. I like Jif.
We just got to get our hands on some tamales.
I do too, man.
I'll take a bite of a tamale with peanut butter on it, but I'm eating the rest of that damn tamale. And that's the whole point.
Well, no. We're going to smear that peanut butter all over that tamale.
All right, Ted, let me ask you. Would you try plain popcorn dipped in warm peanut butter? That's what one person eats.
Oh, it's just going to ruin the peanut butter, but yeah.
Peanut butter dipped in clam chowder.
I'm not a big on clam.
No.
Really? I would do that before I do the peanut
butter. You can't mix the peanut butter in the sea?
Yes, you can.
For what?
Okay. You get some rare tuna with a peanut sauce.
All right.
That's the only thing I can think of. That's the one. But to me, if you're going to mix peanut butter with any fish, it would have to be tuna. And again, I'm not talking about mixing a can of tuna fish with peanut butter. Not that. But like an actual tuna steak and making a peanut sauce.
All right.
That is as close as they can get.
Yeah, I mean, there's no
way. That's it.
Yeah.
My evil laugh is because now I'm thinking about a can of tuna with no mayonnaise.
Just peanut butter.
Okay, all right, Ted, I got a
sure crunchy.
Ted, I got a fresh Maine lobster, right?
All right.
And I pull the tail out, and I just slather the entire top in peanut butter.
Can I still dip it in butter?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I don't know what it is. I guess I really like peanut butter.
I love it, too.
I really like peanut butter. I don't like it everywhere. It's like a relationship. Baby, I love you. We're having a boys' weekend. You know, this is the bacon without the asparagus. That's all.
Oh, I'm going to be the smotherer in this relationship. Peanut butter, you're coming everywhere with me.
Everywhere.
What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Whatever you like, I like now.
Hello, Drevik. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, bitches.
Hola.
How you guys doing?
Doing great, man. Positive Friday.
Positive Friday.
Oh, I'm feeling pretty positive, too.
Thank nice. You,
well, I got a twofer for you. Right. They actually went together. When I was younger, I had milk with soda.
Mixed together.
And I had it on the same night. I had Thanksgiving in a cup.
You couldn't afford plates, or what do you mean?
No, I had already had my first and second portion. I just decided to take my third one, throw everything in a blender, and just blend it all up.
And how was it?
It was actually not so bad. I believe I did it because my mom was trying to make me eat cranberries, and I'm not the biggest fan. So I was like, you know what? I'll eat them, but I'm going to throw everything with it in the blender.
Okay, I understand the logic.
Now the Coke and the milk, does that end up tasting like a cream soda?
It did. I mean, I've tried it with Coke. I mean, if you do it with root beer, it just kind of tastes like a root beer float.
Except it's not a root beer float. It's like crab meat with a K.
Yeah, but if you have a root beer float, it's root beer with one scoop of vanilla ice cream, which can't be too far away from the flavor of that, right?
But milk does not taste like vanilla.
No,
it does just
not.
The same color. It's like, I'm going to drink a can of latex paint because it's white. It's like, it's not vanilla. Milk does not taste like vanilla. It just doesn't.
That started because my mom told me I wasn't allowed to have soda one night, and so I just kind of poured a half a cup of soda and a half a cup of milk and tried to trick her and realized I really liked it.
Other time I've even heard that was from the TV show Laverne and Shirley, because one of the characters would drink Pepsi and milk, and every time she did it, the studio audience was like, ugh.
Okay, I got to ask you. It sounds like you had a lot of food rules in your house. Were you allowed to leave the table before you cleaned your plate?
Not when I was younger. Not when my dad was around.
Okay. And what was the hardest thing for you to eat at the time?
What?
I said, what would you say was the hardest thing for you to eat at that point in time that your parents made regularly?
Probably all of my mom's cooking. My mom had kind of a Cajun cookbook back in the day. You know, she kind of burnt everything. Right.
What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Geico asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, Geico can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and Geico is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to geico.com or contact your local agent today. All right, let's clear this garage. Start a pile here for donations, one over here for recycling, and one more over here for trash. Hang on, what are you doing?
Recycling?
We may need that paint one day, and that can't be recycled.
First, this can looks older than me. And second, paintcare.org says you can.
Paintcare.org. Let me see. Oh, and there's a drop-off site close by. And it's free? Nice.
Dad, no.
You're in the men's room. 99.9 KISW and KISW HD1 Seattle.
We're doing it live. It's just a lot different this year for Live Day 2020. Tuesday, yeah. November 10th, right here live on the radio on our Facebook page, KISW.com. We will stream the shenanigans your way, everything. That day will be completely live on BJ and Migs and our show. The sound effects, the commercials, every single song
even
you hear.
Even the spoons. We actually have to set off mortars.
In this studio.
In this studio,
nothing
that's right.
Nothing is pre-recorded.
We have to get a cow, a dog, and a monkey.
Yeah.
And a random bird. We need a random bird.
Okay. Don't worry. We will pay the monkey.
All right. We're going to have
We're
have people all across the country jumping in to help us. And you can watch this all go down at KISW.com. Live Day is presented by our great friends and the Advocates. Check it out. Tuesday, November 10th. It's going to be different. It's going to be a lot of fun. Unfortunately, as you know, no live crowds at all this year in anything. So trust
None
me.
That.
When we say
I got to break glasses.
We'd love to go up to the casino and hang out. But this year, that is just that's not possible. So it's going to be.
See this?
I'm going to get really high during
birthdays.
I got that.
That's a good call.
Ted, can you bring that in?
Because it's live.
That sound effect?
I don't have one.
I got one.
You got a bubble or anything like that?
I do. I got one for
Mike's
my birthday.
Not a bomb. Yeah. Okay, great.
Yeah, we got that call. We need
what
the monkey.
What about the sound of the beers opening? I'll handle that.
We'll
what
take
about this one?
All of this.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got that too. Mike's got that.
Okay, Mike's got the
Gen 4.
All the details on this year's
Large
Live
animal.
Day. It's at KISW.com. All right, our question, what did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
This is a comment that came in. It says, weird food combos. My three-year-old daughter, she likes eating her mint chocolate chip ice cream with yellow mustard.
Oh, God.
Now, listen, I don't know anything about your kid.
I'm a fan of yellow mustard.
You're going to like what I have to say later. It's going to sound harsh right now. You need to put her ass up for adoption. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Like, that could not live in my home. You could not mix yellow mustard and pistachio ice cream in my home and still live there.
Yeah.
You could be a guest, but you can't live it. You cannot sleep under this roof if that's the combo you're going to eat. Maybe it's harsh. I'm just saying,
you'll thank me in
the future.
You brought up grandparents earlier. My grandfather loved chocolate chip mint ice cream.
Sure.
That was his favorite ice cream of all time. I mean, if he saw that, he's like, oh, my God. You know, especially if it was green.
Did he put mustard on it?
Oh, yeah. No, but he put mustard on his bologna sandwich every single day on white bread. That's all he
had. Oh, yeah.
One piece of bologna, some yellow mustard, two white pieces of bread. That's what he ate. He would eat Vienna sausages. He would eat sardines from a can in oil, not mustard.
My father used to do that. It was when I was a kid, Vienna sausages, I thought it was like a treat. So he'd open a can. There was like five or six stuck in that jelly. And he'd like toss me one, and I thought it was great, right? So my memory was that they were awesome. Then I tried it again as an adult, and I'm like, oh, my God, this is the most disgusting meat product I have put in my mouth.
Sure. And then he put a whole sardine on a cracker and go, here, try it. I'm like, Granddad, it's the whole fish.
Right.
There's bones in there and everything. So I'll just chew them up. They're fine.
You'll be okay.
Yeah. What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Hello, Desiree. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Did I get your name right?
Yes, you did.
Hell yeah. How do you spell Desiree?
Desire with an extra E.
Oh, ooh. Okay. I thought it'd be Desire.
Oh, sexy. Desire with an extra E.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Desiree.
So my grandparents, I thought it was the weirdest thing. Like, you can't knock until you try it. But they used to toast their bread and then put mayonnaise on one side, peanut butter on the other, and then put pickles in it. Now, it was the weirdest thing, but it was interesting.
That is interesting, and it's also something I can knock before I try it. Mm-hmm. And only because I will never try it. Therefore, all I can do is... You said it's toast with peanut butter, mayonnaise, and a pickle?
Yes.
See, Desiree, I don't understand how the pickle
Come
keeps
on,
showing up.
Ted, seriously.
Why does the pickle...
Seriously. Seriously, I bring in a toasted sandwich with mayonnaise, peanut butter, and pickle, and you're going to give this a try.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I might be able to pull that off right now, depending on what's in the refrigerator. Maybe BJ and Migs won't care if I get into their stash. I bet they have
or
all
they
stuff
might.
Right there.
I think the hardest part is finding bread.
I had the pickles. Yeah. I don't know.
Mike is checking now.
Not sure where they came up with it, but I was
it's
like.
It's easy. They were broke.
That is weird.
They were broke or they were high or both.
Were they living high on the hog?
No.
No.
Okay.
You know how we know? Because they ate toast with peanut butter and mayonnaise and pickles. Now, obviously you tried it. You said it was interesting. But say on a 1 to 10 scale, where would you rate this?
Probably like a 6-7 because
really?
I had it before. Okay. And I made my friend try it before.
What was their traditional dish then? Like for dinners and families and things like that. If that's lunch, what's dinner?
It depends on what my grandma was in the mood for making, because they used to RV for years, so she would get recipes from people in RV parks and try those. So like
that would be a cookbook I'd read.
I'd read it.
Yeah, I would be very curious to find out. Go knock on your neighbor's trailer and ask them if they have any dry yeast.
Right.
You just want to pour that directly in a glass of water and
yeah.
Someone says, when I was a kid, I would eat a toasted peanut butter and jelly sandwich with bologna, ketchup, mustard, and dill pickles.
Oh, God.
I'll tell you what. You are a disgusting cretin.
A toasted PB&J is great.
It is
good. Oh, yeah.
That's
but not when you add
the
bologna,
peanut butter gets a little melty.
Mm-hmm.
But they add bologna, ketchup, mustard, and pickles. Like, what is wrong
with
you?
Did you guys ever eat an egg sandwich growing up?
Sure.
Yeah, that was one of my favorites.
Yeah.
Just an egg sandwich, man.
You know what I used to do when I was a kid? Was we get English muffins,
mm-hmm.
a little butter, and then I just put garlic salt on it.
That's not bad either.
No, it's kind of like garlic bread.
All right. But, well, yeah,
breakfast
yeah.
style.
Yeah, but breakfast garlic bread.
But it depends on
you can't go wrong with an English muffin, though.
You should not
to me,
be able to go
the
wrong.
The English muffin is the most underrated bread product on the planet.
It's not used to know. My kids got into it for a while, so I had not had an English muffin in like 30 years, and I was like, this is pretty goddamn good.
I mean, just as a snack at night. You know what I mean?
Toasted
English muffin.
If I make a breakfast sandwich, like once in a while, I'll be like, you know what? I'm going to make breakfast sandwiches. Yeah. It has to be on a muffin.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You won't just do toast?
No.
If they offer toast when you go get breakfast, typically they have an English muffin. Always get the English muffin.
I realized I was getting old when they would offer me toast, and now I take it. Like, for most of my life, I'm like, I don't need toast. I got this, and this. Now I'm like, yes, please, and butter.
I'm going to put some jelly on one piece.
It's amazing how good buttered toast is.
Yeah,
it's just a basic ass thing.
The other's for dipping the yolk. This one is for the jelly. What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Hello, Steve. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, bitches.
Hola.
Okay, well, here's one that I highly recommend you do not try, Ted. Okay,
all right.
Please
all right.
do not try this. My late stepdad, Stanley, used to make a thing he called spaghetti a la Stanley, okay? And so he would cook up the spaghetti noodles, and he would brown up the hamburger, you know, drain the fat, no seasoning on the hamburger, and then he would put that, you know, together, and then he'd get a bottle of ketchup, usually like Del Monte or Hunt's, not even Heinz, and he would just pour the ketchup all over there and then mix it all up and stir it all up, and voila!
Voila! I don't know if voila.
That does not deserve voila.
No. Voila means ta-da.
It was vile.
Yeah.
It was heinous.
It does not deserve voila, ta-da, presto, none of that. Yeah. It gets none of that.
He just
what
lost
it gets
me.
Is this. Here.
Yeah, right.
That's
it gets.
Eat it. He lost me at the brand of ketchup.
Yes, dude, it goes such a long way.
That's back to your childhood, though. Based on the fact that ketchup was one of those things that my parents just did not buy the name brand because they figured that they could chintz on it. So, like, with our school lunches, it was always the cheapest ketchup.
Sure.
At home, it was always the cheapest ketchup. So that's just what I knew. It wasn't that I like it.
But
think
now
it's
that you've experienced Heinz, you know, fancy ketchup, you still insist, well, is it Del Monte or Hunt's?
I like homemade chicken soup a lot.
Or
chicken and dumplings. But Lipton noodle soup. That's just fine with me, too. You know what I mean? It's not like I need the best.
No, I know. I'm just saying, like, there's certain things you eat when you're a kid or maybe don't have much money. But as you get older, you can afford it. I think you can afford Heinz, dude.
Okay, Heinz. Let me ask you a question. Is that the only one that matters? What if it's just a store brand, you know, Fred Meyer brand yellow mustard?
I wouldn't know.
Mustard.
There's a lot more. Specifically yellow mustard.
Yellow mustard, to me, it's all about the same. It's all about
well, the French's would be what? That would be the one.
Right, that's the one you know. But basically, any other yellow mustard is going to be in a container that looks exactly like French's, because I kind of hope you don't notice, right?
Right.
Until the checkout. But usually it's not. Like, yeah, mustard to me, eh. But ketchup is very different. Like, you know Heinz ketchup, you know Del Monte ketchup, and you know Hunt's. With the yellow mustards, like, if you said name French's, I don't know. Out of the ketchups, you say name Heinz, that one.
And not that I don't like really fancy barbecue sauce, but the cheap barbecue sauce, that is just fine. That works out just fine for me.
If I have barbecue sauce, it's always Sweet Baby Ray.
Really?
Yeah, I stand by it.
Have you got their sweet honey mustard yet?
Oh, can't keep it in the house.
It's unbelievable.
Because before you know
it, you just pour it on your hand and lick your hand.
Well, yeah, it's going on a little piece of lunch meat, and then before you know it, it's just on your finger. Right. You're sucking just your sucking finger. Mustard. Yeah, I'm serious. Trust I bought me. One bottle of it. It was like, nope,
don't
nope.
do it. Don't do it.
I can't find me.
Right. I'm addicted to this honey mustard.
I had a lot of food off my finger late at night. What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
There's one way to do it.
God, man. That's why they love you.
Yeah.
What's under your nail? Let me lick it.
Hello, Steve. Welcome to the men's room. Hello, Steve.
Hola, huicholas.
Hola.
So growing up, we had a little thing around the family table. You know, you had to eat everything on your plate. If you didn't finish your dinner, then, you know, you sat there until it was gone. And my parents used to love hominy.
Hominy?
Hominy. Yeah.
I like it now, but I agree. As a kid, I hate it.
I'm not sure I'm on the hominy tip.
Grits, basically.
Oh. I've never heard it called hominy before.
Well, hominy is like real grits, and then there's the grits that most of us ended up eating. Like
so
that.
What does hominy do different? No butter? No cheese?
It's not that. I mean, you cook it the same way, but it's a better quality than the like, stuff in the big, tall... kind of container thing. It's
hominy's like, I usually eat it with like Mexican food.
You get with Mexican food, you get a lot of like Cajun cuisine and all that. Maybe that's why I like it as an adult, because when I eat it, it is with very spicy other stuff.
I love it. Mike and I were talking about it earlier. I think it's great. Yeah, I never had it till like 5 years ago.
That's
and I was
right,
like,
yeah.
Where has this been? But again, I like grits, which is a lot of people don't.
Okay? I don't.
So what would you serve hominy? Grits. What would you serve? What would your parents serve hominy with?
It was just plain. Nothing with it.
That's ridiculous. It
was,
yeah, right.
So that was the entire meal?
The stench of it. Oh, well, no. It'd be like popsicles.
Hold on. We're waiting to get the picture up here. And there it is.
I mean, I'll give it a shot.
I'm going to make some this weekend to go with my tacos.
I mean, again, like I said, if you're eating it with something else, it's not so bad.
Where do
it's
I
like
find
mashed
this?
Potatoes.
Where do I find this in the grocery store?
Like canned aisle, by probably down from the tomatoes.
Is it in the vegetable area?
No.
Okay. All right.
Never down heard. From the stewed tomatoes and,
yeah, all
and
that
the
kind
tomato
of stuff.
Paste, like that kind of area.
All right. Okay.
Whatever. What is that aisle called?
Well, that's normally like...
Is that sauces? Is it canned food? I feel like when you look, yeah. It doesn't say like canned food anymore. It's like real specific, but somehow you know what it is. I just can't remember what they call it. Like, where do you keep your canned food?
Is it maybe sir. The soup aisle? And it starts with the vegetables and the canned fruits?
Maybe.
My favorite is the international food aisle. I always just walk by and go, what is that?
That means 90% Asian, right? I mean, when you go over there.
Yeah. There's the UK section, you know what I mean? There's the
really?
Well, yeah, it's
come
like,
on.
Where are you going to buy your Pimps?
Right.
Or my spotted dick or
all
my skinless bangers.
All those things are in there. Your biscuits, the whole deal.
What do you got there, Mike?
It says that you can find it in either the canned bean section or the Mexican food section.
Okay.
Right. Canned beans.
See,
all
that's
right.
Where I'd find it. What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK.
Hello, Renee. Welcome to the men's room.
Hi, guys.
Hola.
So I have a couple of things. My cousin and my grandfather, which my grandfather got her hooked on it, but he would take saltine crackers, mash them up, and put it in milk and eat it like cereal.
Oh, no. Oh,
good God.
Oh, no. I thought you were going to tell me, like, put it in chili. You know,
I did not say milk
soup or something like
he
that.
He also ran a meth lab. I mean, I just, yeah.
No. And then my ex would mix up ketchup and mayonnaise and put it on everything. And I mean everything.
Well, that's technically a fry sauce.
Of,
yeah. Right. It's the
yeah,
secret
but
sauce
on
of so many.
Spaghetti?
Oh, no.
Was this
lasagna,
the
enchiladas, beans?
Can I ask you a question? Did you cook a lot of the food?
Oh yeah, and I was pissed.
I was gonna say that would really dig at me, man, because
I was like, you're ruining
this.
My food.
Right, exactly. And you're right. He is. It's a good thing you dumped his ass.
Yes.
I thought she was going to say, no, he dumped me, actually. We had a very loving marriage.
Yeah, but he left me for the neighbor. Because she put that on everything.
Yeah. And I was pissed.
What did you or do you eat that other people just don't understand? 206-421-ROCK. I don't blame her.
Hostility is still fresh.
She's still mad.
Renee doesn't say, like, oh, man, it used to make me mad. It was, and I got pissed.
Renee is right.
No, she is right.
She's absolutely right.
Especially if they slather before you've taken a bite.
Yeah.
Like, mother God. Hello, Kent. Welcome to the men's room.
Coors, whores, and sores.
Ooh.
Hola.
Hey, Ken, whatever you're into. That's a lovely combo.
Sores. Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's what happens if you have too much of the first two.
Yeah.
Anyway, if you guys like mustard and aren't disgusted by this dish, I implore you to try this because it's really, really good. First of all, I got to say, I'm not a big mayonnaise fan. I hated it as a kid. I like it now. It's fine. But I only put it on a few things, you know, club sandwich, turkey sandwich, stuff like that. But one thing I do not put it in, which everybody does, the whole world, is tuna fish. Now, tuna fish and mustard. This is where I'm going. You don't have to drown the tuna fish in mustard like you do mayonnaise, but you get dill mustard, if you can get that. It's best to go that way. Get some dill mustard. Get some dill relish. You put your couple cans of tuna fish in a bowl. You get as generous as you want with the relish and the mustard. I don't go too heavy, but you want it to taste. And you mix it up. Put it on some nice fresh croissant, any kind of bread you like, but it's really good on a croissant. Some nice, real thin sliced ripe tomato, and you got a heck of a sandwich there.
Sounds good.
Fantastic.
It's not the worst.
I've done mustard and tuna. Back when I was super broke, I mixed mustard and tuna for the obvious reason. Mayonnaise is not my favorite, so that's not where I'm going to spend my money. It wasn't that bad. Now, that said, since that time, I have not repeated that.
No, I've done it before. Like, make mayonnaise, like regular tuna fish, and then add in a little bit of mustard.
I've added in later, but I'm saying just the can of tuna and the mustard, that's your whole thing. Like, it wasn't that bad. But now that I don't have to do that, I don't.
Have you ever taken a croissant, cut it in half, put chocolate in the middle, and put it in the microwave for about 30 seconds?
Dude, you
know.
Ted! Come
just
on,
take
man.
Take your croissant, cut it in half like a sandwich. Take your Hershey bar, put like 3 or 4 pieces in there. Close it up, put it in the microwave for like 30 seconds. Oh, my God.
Can you do it in the toaster oven?
You can do it in the toaster oven. You can be Mr. Fancy Pants. Just know that there'll be a lot of crumbs.
I don't have a microwave.
Okay. Dude, seriously. You can put a dog turd on a croissant, and that dog turd...
Everything croissant's better.
I was just like, yes, croissant. Croissant is the difference maker. Still to come, the exciting return of Bad Choice Friday. Get to voting when you follow us on Twitter and Men's Room Live. We're doing a little spooky one today with DJ Jazzy Jeff and Fresh Prince. A Nightmare on My Street taking on Ray Parker Jr. and Ghostbusters. Again, vote now when you follow us on Twitter at Men's Room Live.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.